Hey there. Today I want to talk about HTTPX and asynchronous sending of requests and one possible way how we can implement rate limiting. So what do I mean exactly? I guess let's just start with an example. I decided to use some kind of an API. This one is just about getting some information about a Pokemon. This is what it returns, right? Let's see, some kind of a JSON. It doesn't really matter, but the idea is that we want to send a lot of requests to this API and ideally asynchronously, or in other words, more or less at the same time. However, we don't want to send too many requests, or in other words, we don't want to overwhelm the API. And HTTPX, to my knowledge, does not have this feature inside of itself, and you kind of need to use the standard library package async.io to do this, and there's this object called Semaphore. So that's what I want to show you today. So first of all, let us start by writing a script where we don't do any rate limiting. This might take some time, but bear with me. So let's call this a script, py. So first of all, we import all the stuff. So we import async.io, then we import logging to kind of know what is going on. And finally, we import HTTPX. Let's instantiate logger. We will use the root logger, doesn't really matter. And here, let me just switch off logging coming from HTTPX itself, otherwise things would get a little bit too verbose. So get logger HTTPX and let's set the level equal to logging warning. Yeah, basically any info messages or debug messages would be hidden by default. And yeah, let's set up the logger formatting and verbosity. So we do format, let's say, doesn't really matter that much. We want to get the time. I believe that's how one does it. And then the message. Yeah. Hopefully this is correct. And of course, we also want to specify the level. Let's say we will go for logging info. And let me maybe indent this in some nicer way. Cool. Yeah, this is good enough, right? And eventually we need to kind of write this sending of the request logic, and to do this, let's just write an async function. So async definition send request, right? And it will hold some kind of a or it will accept some kind of a client. Let's actually call this HTTPX async client, or let's provide type hints directly. I think this should work. And it will return the status code. So 200 if everything went fine, right? And yeah, the URL, I'm just going to copy paste this. Doesn't matter again. In real applications, this will be probably changing, but for us, this will be always the same Pokemon that we want to get information on. And here, let's just log some messages. So let's say that here we're sending the request. Here, after this, we are actually going to await the response, right? So current get URL. And finally, we do logger info response received. And we return the response in just the status code, right? We don't care about the response body. This is the atomic sending of a request. But what do you want to do, right? We want to send a bunch of these. We want to run this function a lot of times at the same time. So let's write some kind of a wrapper logic around this. Again, this is going to be an async function. Let's do something like this. And this is, let's say, a syntax specific to HTTPX. I suggest you kind of check out the documentation, but I have it in my notes, so I will just write it out. HTTPX async client. So we instantiate this async client that also is a context manager. And we create a list of tasks. So async.io create task. Create task send request, which is the function we just implemented, right? And we kind of provide the client because we don't want to create the client every time we have a new request. We just want to use the same one. And let's do something like this. Cool. And finally, what we are going to do is to just collect the status codes, and we need to await gather and tasks. So this is how you basically make sure that all of these requests are sent out at the same time. And here, once all of the responses are received, we basically will get to this line of code. And finally, logger info to just say all work done, right? And the way we let's actually maybe also return something, some kind of an exit code, because this will be our main function. So let's do return zero if all codes are equal to 200, right? For in status codes else one. So basically what this means, if we received correct responses for every single request, we return an exit code to zero, meaning the program finish without any issues. Otherwise, we return a one. And just the standard Python boilerplate here, we basically just make sure that the return of the main function is transferred into an exit code of the program. So async.io run, this is how we actually launch the async logic, and I think this should be it. So this was a lot of code. Let's try whether this works. So if I do Python script, there is no module HTTPX. That's a good point. So let's try to install it. Let's install HTTPX, and let's try to run this, right? So what's important here, let me zoom out, is that we are sending out 10 requests, and let's see what we get. Yeah, so as you can see, from the logger messages, we first send out all of the 10 requests, and only then we started receiving responses, right? But you can argue that, you know, this is a little bit dangerous because, let's say, the server you're sending these requests to might be something you are maintaining or you are deploying, and you don't want to overwhelm it, or if it's some third-party server, you might be blocked, right? And as I said, to my knowledge, in HTTPX, there is no way how you can kind of do this easily. So we need to kind of do some extra work. But let me just show you that even if I increase this to 20, right, the logic is always the same. In one moment, we send out all the requests, and then we get all the responses more or less around the same time. And the big question is now, how do we actually implement this rate limiting? And the answer is pretty simple. What you need to do, you need to actually use this Semaphore class within the async.io package. So the place where we insert it is here, right? So we create this semaphore, and the semaphore, once we instantiate it, we need to make sure that we kind of pass it to this send request function as we did with the client. So let's do the instantiation semaphore async.io semaphore, and here the first argument kind of represents the maximum number of outstanding requests for which we haven't received a response yet. So let's just set it to one, right? That's one extreme case. And what do we need to do here? Let's, as I said, pass it over to the send request function, semaphore. And also here, let's do semaphore and let's do async IO semaphore. Something like this looks good. And here, the last modification we need to do is to use the semaphore as a context manager, async with semaphore. I think that should be it, right? Pretty straightforward. Let's see whether we made it work. So now what we're expecting is that instead of sending all of the 20 requests at the same time, we should send one, wait for the response to get back, and only then go to the next one. So let's see, Python. And voila, as you can see, it's exactly the case. It's always interleaving. So we have sending request, response received, sending request, response received. And as you would imagine, you can kind of play around with this parameter. You can set it to whatever you think is the right semaphore size or queue size. So here, let's verify that it works. So as you can see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 outstanding requests. And we don't send out any new requests. We wait for some of the responses. As soon as we receive one of the responses, at that given moment, we send out a new request. So yeah, I think this is pretty cool. Hopefully it was helpful to you, and I'll see you next time.